Answer time. It's StoryBots answer time.
Answer time.
They live in your computer and they got a job to do. They're all about learning and they make it fun too. Yes. When you have a question, they'll answer it for you. It's StoryBots answer time.
Answer time!
Hi, Bo. Do insects sleep?
Oh, that's a good question. Let's ask.
What the?
What is it, dear?
Just the StoryBots with another one of their cackamamie questions.
Well, I guess that answers the question.
Hey, Bo. Bye-bye.
All right. Not again. Like, never is it the high five.
Wow, Boop! I didn't realize you spoke car. What do they want?
Boop, boop, boop.
Oh, well, why didn't they just say so?
Woo! We got a level 3 coming in, gang!
Oh, StoryBots! StoryBots! I am so happy to see you.
And we're glad to see you, Mr. Cow.
Oh, thank you, Bo. You have no idea how much I appreciate your kindness, given how nervous and jittery I've been.
Have you tried deep breathing? It really helps me when I need to get all centered and stuff.
Funny you should say that. My therapist recommended meditation, but nothing seems to help.
Help with what?
A few weeks ago, I'm out in the field, you know, next to the tractor to grab a bite. Nice juicy patch of grass right there. The grass is always greener on the other side of the tractor. And so all of a sudden, the sky grows dark and it started to rain.
That doesn't sound so bad.
Yeah, rain is a pretty natural occurrence, Mr. Cow.
Oh, StoryBots, no. It wasn't the rain. It was the tractor.
Like, what was wrong with the tractor?
Oh, nothing. Other than the fact that it got sucked straight into the sky!
Whoa! Well, how did that happen?
A twister bing? A tornado? It came out of nowhere, and poof! It was gone! The tractor disappeared out of here!
Oh my gosh! Were you okay?
I was. That time. But what about the next time? Or the time after that?
Boop, boop. Boop.
Look, if a tornado can take a tractor, then it could definitely take a cow! This cow!
I'm sorry, Mr. Cow, but I don't think we can help you stop a tornado.
Oh, no. I don't need you to help me stop one, Beep. I just need you to help me understand how they form. You know, that way I can spot one coming in advance and then get myself to safety.
Oh, that sounds reasonable enough.
Sure does.
So you can help me, right? You can tell me how tornadoes are formed?
Oh, there's a weather documentary playing at the Majestic Movie Complex.
I hear it's full of tornadoes.
Ooh, that's an awesome idea.
Fantastic, StoryBots. Thank you so much. But please, please hurry. Every minute I spend waiting for an answer is another minute a tornado could come and take me away.
Don't worry, Mr. Cow. We are on the job.
Answer time!
Hi, StoryBots. Can you tell me a fun fact?
Fun fact number 89,827,369.
Did you know that if you could drive a car at 60 miles per hour straight into the sky, it would only take about an hour to get to space?
Here we are, kids. Outer space. Have you ever seen anything like it?
It's awesome. So amazing.
I have to go to the bathroom.
Couldn't you have thought of that before we left the Earth?
Hey, StoryBots, what's your favorite animal?
I have finally done it, Egad! I have invented the strangest creature the world has ever seen!
Oh, dear.
By diabolically combining a mouse and a pigeon, I give you... Reginus Mousus!
Hey, turn on that light!
Aw, it's a little bat.
Little what?
A bat. It's a flying mammal that looks like a mouse and has wings like a bird, even though it's not actually related to either.
Wait, flying mammals are already a thing?
Yeah, it can also navigate in the dark.
Oh, why can I never invent anything weirder than nature? Why?
Next stop, StoryBots Majestic Movie Complex.
Hello, and welcome to the Majestic Movie Complex. How can I help you today?
One ticket for the weather documentary, please.
Ah, excellent choice. A true meteorological tour de force. But there's just one tiny little problem.
Oh? What's that?
Oh, we don't have any screens to show the movie.
Oh my gosh, what happened?
Well, it started to get really windy, and then all of a sudden, there was this loud train sound, and...
Keep your eyes peeled, gang! That tornado must be somewhere around here!
Wait, did you say tornado?
Of course I did! What else do you think could have caused this kind of devastation?
Hey, I know you! You're that famous weather documentarian, Chase Weathers!
Oh, that's right! Me and my team have been tracking down strange weather patterns for my next project.
This fall, prepare yourself for the most electrifying half hour of television.
Plus ads.
When we premiere. When Weather Attacks.
Volume 12.
Join Chase Weathers and his elite storm-chasing team as they brave flash floods, blizzards in sub-zero temperatures, devastating 100% humidity.
And more.
When Weather Attacks.
Volume 12.
The last thing I need to complete my special is footage of a real-life tornado!
Hey, boss! Looks like we got a sighting at the old Paxton Farm! I repeat, there's a tornado at the old Paxton Farm!
Okay, gang! Let's roll!
Hey, Chase! Think I can tag along?
That depends. Do you think you have what it takes to be an elite storm trucker?
Maybe?
Good enough for me. Let's roll! All right, newbie, time to catch up to speed. Luckily, we have the best weather tracking technology premium cable can afford. Our computer picked up the formation of a larger thunderstorm known as the supercell, which can lead to the biggest and most destructive tornadoes.
Got it.
Now, do you see here how the wind near the ground is moving in this direction?
Yep.
And the wind above it is moving in a different direction?
I see.
Well, when that happens, the two winds can merge to form a spinning, horizontal tube of air.
Whoa, that's awesome!
That's nothing. The true awesomeness comes from when there's condensation in the clouds.
Why is that?
Because the heat pulls the spinning funnel of air up towards the sky. We see the funnel getting pulled up. And when the funnel connects the clouds on the high end, touching the ground on the low end, well, that's when we get...
Tornado!
Come on, team, grab your camera. We got a live one!
Hey, StoryBots, how big is the tallest tree?
Boy, that white-headed woodpecker nest sure is high up there.
Yeah, that's one heck of a big tree, Doink.
Say, Dank, how tall do you think the tallest tree is?
Oh, I don't know. I'd say it's at least 6 feet tall.
6 feet tall? Are you out of your mind? If that's any taller than 5 feet, then I'm a red-breasted sapsucker.
Wait. If you think the tallest tree in the world is only 5 feet tall, then you're a sucker, all right, but you ain't a bird.
But you don't know anything about trees.
Oh, yeah, my middle name is Trees.
All right, that's it. I cannot go bird watching with someone who thinks trees can be 6 feet tall.
Why, I can't go bird watching with someone who thinks trees are only 5 feet tall.
Fine, then I'm packing my binoculars and heading home.
Good,
Dink.
Good,
Dink.
Good,
Dink.
Doink,
Dink.
Doink,
Dink.
Doink, Dink.
Goodbye.
Doink,
goodbye.
Doink,
goodbye.
Only
please excuse my interruption, but I'm sorry to say that you are both slightly off in your calculations. On average, most large trees can grow between 40 and 100 feet tall, but the tallest tree on record is a California redwood that grew to roughly 380 feet tall. That's taller than a 30-story building.
Yeah, right, lady. And I'm J. Edgar Hoover.
380 feet? This bear must think we were born yesterday.
Come on, Dick.
Let's get out of here, doink.
This bear wouldn't know a redwood tree from a kitchen sink.
Measuring trees, measuring trees, from the bottom of the trunk to the top of the leaves. How tall are those? How tall are these? You gotta find out by measuring trees. Some are real tall, others are short, others are more of an in-between sort. But most big trees, when their growth is complete, get to be between 40 and 100 feet. But that's not the highest that a tree can go. Some are way bigger, yeah, they grow and grow. There's a super-sized redwood that tops them all. It's about 380 feet tall. That's 32 fire trucks stacked up high, even much higher than most kites fly. With so many sizes and varieties, you're sure to see a lot when you're measuring trees. Tall ones, small ones, bushy ones, all kinds of trees.
Next stop, Chase Weather's storm tracking van.
All right, gang, follow that tornado! Something that goes around destroying everything.
Well, it's not like I enjoy being destructive. Deep down inside, I'm just a wisp of wind.
Woe is me, once I was a simple breeze. Whoa, that is my fondest recollection. A faster breeze blew over me. In a different direction, we formed a tube of spinning air,
horizontal near the ground.
Meanwhile, the sky above was stormy,
full of dark and heavy clouds,
with lightning flashing everywhere
and the thunder booming loud.
A massive supercell had formed. What a storm! Such a sad and bitter tale.
Tornado, and informative.
Oh, listen, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to call you a meanie. How about we start fresh? Get to know each other. What do you say, friend?
Friend? I've never had one of those before.
Well, I'd love to stay, but I've got an answer to deliver. Thanks for all your help, everyone. Bye!
So long, Beep.
And team, you might want to grab your umbrellas, because something tells me there's about to be a downpour.
Of friendship.
Welcome, class. A tornado is a fast-spinning tube of air. My assistant, Gopher, will demonstrate the formation using my Tornado Simulator ZX9, which lets us observe a tornado in 100% complete safety. Gopher, if you please. When wind near the ground moves in one direction, and wind above it moves in a different direction, it can form a horizontal tube of spinning air. Meanwhile, in the clouds, the condensation that makes rain and hail gives off heat, which makes air near the ground move upward. As this air moves upward, it tilts the horizontal tube of spinning air to an upright position. This upright spinning tube of air can then fall hail, rain, dirt, and other things into it. And when this tube stretches from the cloud to the ground, a tornado is formed. These storms can have huge dark clouds, lightning, thunder, large hail, and strong winds.
Gopher, what have you done to my tornado simulator?
And that's how tornadoes form.
Hello? Mr. Pow, are you there? Come in!
Oh, Beep. Thank goodness you're back. I can't stop thinking about that tractor that got sucked straight into the sky!
Don't worry, Mr. Cow. I've got your answer. I know how tornadoes form.
Oh, I feel safer already. What do you got for me?
Well, tornadoes start to form when winds blowing in opposite directions create a horizontal tube of spinning air.
Okay, tube of air. Got it. What's next?
When rain and hail form in the clouds, it generates heat, which can cause the tube of spinning air to tilt upwards towards the sky.
Oh, okay. So a tube of air starts tilting upward because of the heat.
And if the top of the tube touches the storm cloud and the bottom touches the ground...
That's how tornadoes form!
You got it!
Oh, thank you, Beep. But to be honest, I'm still a bit of a nervous wreck.
Are you still thinking about that tractor getting sucked up into the sky?
No. Now I'm thinking about it coming down. On me!